Hey everybody, I'm Garrick, this is Van.
Hi.
We are doing our first impression review of Steam Park over here, which is a pretty big game. It's in a big box. But we're looking at this game because it is a Euro-style game in many ways, right?
It's a Euro-style game with some random elements in it.
Random elements, which the elements happen to be steampunk. It's all about building a park for steam-powered robots. Am I right?
Yeah. I mean, they work all year round, and then they get 6 days of vacation. So you come and build a park for them for just the 6 days.
Because robots have feelings, too. What better break can you take than go to an amusement park dedicated to your particular robot?
That's true.
That's true. Have you ever heard of the Steam-Powered Giraffe?
No.
Oh, this is a band. They were street performers. But what makes them most notable is that they dress up like clockwork androids. They have face paint. They have mannerisms like robots. It is amazing because this group has not only started off as street performers, but they have now moved on to drawing hundreds to their shows, as well as going to cons like steampunk cons or just large events. So congratulations to them, because for any performer to start off on the streets and then 7 years later have a copyright of their own and give me permission to use their stuff, I'm just saying, I got permission by them because they're awesome.
So they just do music?
They don't just do music. They have vaudevillian acts in their interchange too. So I'm definitely putting a link on our channel about them. So you guys should definitely check them out.
Absolutely.
So now we're talking about Steam Park. We have 6 days to build an amusement park for our robots.
Yep.
What do we need to do?
Well, we need to roll a bunch of dice, and on the dice are a bunch of different faces. We need to build different types of amusement park rides, as well as different little booths here that'll help us throughout the game. But it's a fast-paced game where we're all rolling simultaneously. So you roll dice, and you keep rolling dice until you get what you want. And the first person who gets it will get the number one ticket.
Okay, so it's a race, too. So not only are you rolling dice, but you're trying to get what you want.
Right.
But you're trying to race to see who goes first.
You're trying to race to see who goes first, and you're trying to not accumulate a bunch of dirt, because robots create a bunch of dirt.
Oh, yeah, of course. Because they're steam energy robots. It's coal, right? So steam. Yeah, actually, that makes sense. Why it's a shovel, I think, I'm looking at. Anyway, so we race for it, we grab it. Is there a reward for getting it first?
Yeah, you get to clean a bunch of dirt. So in this game, there's a bunch of dirt that you could have for it. And at the end of the game, if you have too much dirt, you lose the game automatically. Ooh. Because the city fines you for having too much dirt. Clean robot city.
Of course. Yeah. Robots want to be clean. Why not? Us humans, not so much. You know, I noticed there's a pig over here.
Yeah, your steam pig?
Yeah.
Sure.
It's a steam pig?
Well, it's actually a clockwork pig.
It's a clockwork pig.
Yeah, it looks like a little bank on the top, too.
So, my understanding is that you roll the dice, and then when the thing that you want, you have to put it on the pig.
Yes, you feed the pig dice, and then as soon as the pig is full, you're going to take your ticket.
You feed the pig dice.
Sure. Robot pigs eat dice, you know?
Robot pigs eat dice.
You don't know about that?
Now I know. I hear if the dice rolls on the pig, you can't grab it out afterwards.
Yeah, that would be a little weird.
It's a robot pig.
Would it just eat whatever? Yeah, sure. Robot pig, robot goat.
Robot goat?
I don't know. Well, how can you beat giant pigs that are 16 times the size of a robot? I'd be very intimidated.
Well, maybe that's a corporate thing. I also noticed that we have possible missions that we can have.
Oh, yeah, you have little bonus cards here. So all the bonus cards give you bonus points if you roll different dice. And you can use one per die you roll.
And,
so these will give you points and extra money. So the goal of the game is, of course, to get the most money.
Oh, makes sense, because robots spend money on you. Anyways, so some of the things that I see on my cards, number of different type of stands in your park.
Mm-hmm.
So the more different types, you can possibly get more money for them.
Right.
This one says different color rides in your park. So if you have a variance of different colors, you can get bonus.
Well, just like humans, right? There are different types of robots. So different robots like different rides.
Really?
Yeah. Of course.
So for each ride that we have to get that particular robot to ride that ride.
Yes. Pink robots like pink rides.
Of course.
And green robots like green rides.
Yeah. Because they're green.
Well, you don't like green rides. You're not a green robot.
No, I'm not. Because I'm not environmentally friendly, apparently. And then you have, this card says a number of purple visitors in your park.
Yep.
So I guess the more rides you create for purple robots, the more points you can possibly get.
If you like to cater to purple robots,
if
absolutely.
If I do, yeah. Mm-hmm.
The best part is that the robots stay on the ride the entire time that you're there. So
really?
If you have a ride from the first day, it'll stay for all 6 days.
Yeah, because they... never stop.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a roller coaster, right? They get on the roller coaster, and no one else can get on the roller coaster because they sit there for 6 days because they're robots. And they pay you every day.
Every day?
Every day.
How do they pay when they're on the ride?
I guess they pay you at the end. Yeah. They just drop their change out of the roller coaster.
But it's true. Yeah. It's true, they're robots, right?
With the dirt.
With the dirt.
With the dirt.
Hey, that's more reason to clean up the place.
That's less of a reason for me to clean up the place.
That's true.
Yeah.
Very true.
Yeah.
So basically, you build, mm-hmm. you expand,
yep.
and you attract.
You attract different robot
wow.
customers, yeah.
To me, that's a really good kind of theme overall. I mean, granted, it's for robots, but it's more than that. You're thinking on multiple levels,
yeah.
which is something that I like about Euro games, is that you have different options to go in. Mm-hmm. What was your first impression of the game?
My first impression of the game was that it's very, very fast-paced. It has that nice
yeah.
dexterity element, but you get to plan after you're done frantically rolling and trying not to get the last one. Because if you're the last one to pick,
yeah.
You get probably the best dice, but you get more dirt. Because you're so slow.
My first impression was, I just like the idea that you're attracting things to rides, because I'm into theme parks. When I go to different theme parks, I love riding the different rides. Universal in Florida
yeah.
has different sections of their parks. I mean, you could go to the Simpsons stuff.
Right.
You can go to the Jurassic Park version. They even have a Harry Potter world that you can visit. And just it's amazing just overall, and I kind of feel like we kind of capture that as well in this game. Granted,
right.
it's not for humans, but it's just fun. That's our first impression review. So.
The music